An urgent call to prayer. The Battle of the Two Horsemen. A Lightworks Ministry video written and created by Martha Newcomb. It all happened one afternoon. It was during my time in prayer when I went into a trance-like state. Then I heard the Lord's voice say, "Look." In this vision, I seen a clear blue sky. Then as I began to focus in on the scene, clouds began to form, covering the sky. As I was observing the dark cloudy sky, I began to hear what sounded like horses galloping and the sounds of thunder. Then God spoke to me and said, "Look over to your left." When I looked to my left, I saw what appeared to be a black horseman riding in the clouds. His presence felt eerie, and I began to have a strange feeling in the pit of my stomach. Then God spoke to me again, saying, "Look to your right." I began to hear another horse galloping from my right side. Then as I looked, I saw a white horseman riding in the clouds. As he was riding, I felt a sense of peace come over me. Then as I was watching the white horseman, I noticed that both horsemen were riding towards each other. I began to feel restless in my spirit. I saw a battle break out in the heavenlies between the black horsemen and the white horsemen. Both had swords and shields and were fighting each other with all their might on their horses. As I saw each horseman fighting each other, both of the horses began to rear or stand on their hind legs. As I was watching the horsemen battle, I began to feel more restlessness in my spirit. As the battle continued, I began to feel increasingly weak and restless. Then I heard God speak to me and said, "Look there." My attention was turned to the hoofs of the white horse, or the horse's feet. I noticed that the hoofs of the white horse were growing weak and fatigued. The white horseman struggled to fight because the white horse was growing weaker and was having trouble holding the weight of the white horseman in battle. As I watched the white horse grow weaker, I said to God, "Lord, why are you showing this to me? What's happening?" I said, "What does this all mean?" He said to me in a mighty voice that sounded like 3-in-1, "The hoofs of this horse represent the prayers of those who belong to me," he continued. "There is a battle going on in the heavenlies, but many have neglected to pray to me. They have become distracted, making it easier for the enemy to attack." He said to me, "My people do not realize the power of prayer and its place in spiritual warfare." God continued, "The horse can only stand firm when my people pray." He said, "The horse represents the church. The white and black horsemen represent the spiritual battle between God's angels and Satan's demons." That was the end of the vision. However, to give you more insight into this vision, I want to take you to Daniel chapter 10. In Daniel chapter 10, verses 12 through 13, it states, "Then he said to me, 'Do not be afraid, Daniel, for from the first day that you set your heart on understanding this and on humbling yourself before your God, your words were heard, and I have come in response to your words. But the prince of the kingdom of Persia was withstanding me for 21 days. Then behold, Michael, one of the chief princes, came to help me, for I had been left there with the kings of Persia." The prince of the kingdom of Persia. In the Bible, it never mentions the identity of the prince of Persia. Some scholars believe that the prince could have been a demon. However, no one can say for sure. But what the Bible does say is that this prince was some form of spiritual resistance that delayed the angel in giving Daniel the message. This resistance was so strong that Michael, the archangel, one of the chief commanders, had to come and help this angel because the angel was left alone with the kings of Persia. I bring this up to tell you to remember our battle is not against flesh and blood. Daniel 10 gives us insight into spiritual warfare and how there is more to the battle than what meets the eye. In Ephesians 6, verses 11 through 12, it says, "Put on the full armor of God, so that you may take your stand against the devil's schemes. For our struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the powers of this dark world, and against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly realms." Listen, brothers and sisters, I can't stress this enough. Put on the full armor of God. That includes the helmet of salvation, the breastplate of righteousness, the belt of truth, the sword of the Spirit, the shield of faith, and the feet of readiness of the gospel of peace. Listen, Satan's kingdom is very real. Its principalities, powers, rulers of darkness, demonic hosts are all part of what influences this world. But we as Christians have been given the armor of God, and we have instant access to God through prayer. And it is only through God that we can defeat the enemy. This is why we need to seriously keep prayer as the number one priority in our life, because that is how we communicate with God and how we call for help. But not only that, it also strengthens us. It strengthens our faith and it strengthens the body. So we need to commit to prayer. Don't forget to pray. And pray in the Spirit on all occasions with all kinds of prayers and requests. With this in mind, be alert and always keep on praying for all the Lord's people. Ephesians 6, verse 11. Watch and pray so that you will not fall into temptation. The Spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak. Matthew 26, verse 41. Devote yourselves to prayer, being watchful and thankful. Colossians 4, verse 2. Remember the two horsemen? Prayer is what strengthened the horse to stand firm in battle. In other words, it is the prayers of God's people that strengthens the church. Believe it or not, we are living in the last days and we are in a spiritual battle with Satan. Therefore, we must seek God and commit to prayer. As we looked in Daniel chapter 10, we could see that spiritual warfare is not as simple as we may think, and that there can be a long struggle or at times a delay. However, we can also see how Daniel's fervent prayers moved the hand of God, brought extra help, and Daniel was able to receive the message that still speaks to us today. An urgent call to prayer. We are living in the last days. Right now, we need God to intervene more than ever. If you know you have not been praying, now is the time to start. So, will you? Will you pray? The question I leave you with today is, will you answer the call? Thank you for watching. God bless.